So, let's start the definitions. Route of drug administration. Route of drug administration is the medium in which an drug is introduced into the body for its action. This action is called pharmacological actions. Route of drug administration. System, local, enteral. System is divided into two parts. One is enteral, another is parenteral. Oral, sublingual, rectal. Parenteral also divided into five parts. Number one, subcutaneous. Number two, intramuscular. Number three, intravenous. Number four, intraarterial. Number five, intradermal. Local, skin, topical, ocular drops, intranasal, enteral route, oral route. It is the most common of drug administration. It is mostly used for the neutral drugs. It may be in the form of tablets, capsule, syrup, emulsion, or powder. Advantage: number one, easy to take. Number two, it is the cheapest. No physician required. Disadvantage: less amount of drug reaches the target tissue. Slow absorption. It might cause gastric irritation. Some of the drug destroyed by gastric juice. Example, insulin. Sublingual route. Involves tablet placed under the tongue or between cheeks. The drug should be lipid soluble and small. Advantage: rapid absorption takes place. Drug is dissolved easily. Drug is enters the blood directly. Disadvantage: this method is inconvenient. Irritation of the mucous member might occur. Person may swallow the drug. Rectal route. Certain irritant and unpleasant can be put into rectum as a suppositories or retention enema for systemic effect. This route can also be used when the patient is having recurrent vomiting or is unconscious. Diazepam, indomethacin, paracetamol, and few other drugs are sometimes given rectally. Advantage: this route is preferred if drug is irritant. This route is preferred in unconscious patients. This route avoids nausea or vomiting. Disadvantage: this route drug is generally not acceptable by the patients due to embarrassment. slow absorption. These routes have 50% fast pass metabolism. Parenteral route. If refers to any route of administration that do not involve drug absorption via GI tract, advantage. It is rapid. It is useful for unconsciousness patients. Bioavailability is 100%. Disadvantage. It is painful. It is less safe. This method is expensive. Intramuscular route. Intramuscular route might be applied to the buttock, thigh, and deltoid. Volume used is 3 ml. Advantage. Absorption is rapid than subcutaneous route. Irritative substance might be given. Disadvantage. This route might cause nerve or vein. Intravenous route. Advantage. Immediate action takes place. Absorption is not required. This route is preferred for unconsciousness patients. Disadvantage. This method is more risky. This is not retreat. Inflammation of surrounding tissue might result. Intra-arterial route. In this route, drugs are administered into an artery. Through this route, anti-cancer drugs are given for localized effects. Advantage. Bioavailability is 100%. High concentrator of drug can be administered at the desired site of action. Disadvantage. It is painful. It is less safe. It is expensive. Intradermal route. In this route, drugs are administered into dermal layer of the skin just beneath the epidermis. Usually, small amount of liquid is used, e.g. example 0.1 ml solution is used. Advantage. Slow absorption, tuberculosis and allergy test. Disadvantage. Amount of drug administered must be small. It is expensive.